So I think when we think about the impact of funding cuts, it's of course first important to think about the impact of cuts on HIV service delivery and services for people who need them. And that's in a very precarious situation right now due to US foreign aid freeze. It was quickly recognized through some of the mathematical modeling that we and others did, the potentially devastating impacts. We could see resurgences in new HIV infections, as well as resurgences in AIDS-related deaths, back to levels that we saw in the mid-2000s at the height of the HIV epidemic. I think in a future without the sort of research that we were doing now, we would really miss opportunities to continue to adapt and evolve our HIV responses to be most efficient and effective, to continue not only maintaining the gains that we've seen in reducing HIV, but continuing to accelerate reductions in HIV infections. The past couple of decades have really been a period of tremendous progress that's really been built on the availability and scale-up of treatment across the world. There's around 39 million people living with HIV globally, over 30 million of them are on lifelong antiretroviral treatment, and that has two impacts. It both prolongs the life of people living with HIV, they can live a near normal life expectancy, healthy long lives. It also stops transmission of HIV if you're on treatment and virally suppressed. In Eastern and Southern Africa, new infections and deaths have both reduced by around 60% since 2010.